We discuss the 21st century skill sets very often, and we have identified that curiosity, building, teaching the children to be able to work in a collaborative manner rather than in a competitive manner, and going towards more of hands-on learning beyond the textbook learning, and learning from nature and their environment. These are the kind of skill sets we would like them. Apart from textual knowledge, intellectual knowledge, a lot of time spent on co-curricular activities, which we in our school called balanced schooling, giving a lot of importance to sports and art and drama and performance, is definitely going to give them that 360 degree skill set which hones their brain, and tomorrow they may continue academically to get degree after degree, or they may go out into a very bold new area and choose games, sports, dance, music, whatever as their future hobby, passion, profession, whatever. So that is very important for school to give rise to that creativity. The curiosity can be built with not telling them, but asking them to find out, putting hints before them, and then asking them to unravel the story of what lies beyond. The teachers these days cannot possibly cover the amount of information that there is. Our children, from a very young age, they are onto internet sources for material, and to a certain extent we want that information literacy, because they must know if they have to research, where they need to go, how much they need to read, and we encourage parents to help them to do that. So teacher cannot be a provider of information, she has to be there to facilitate the usage of that information to create new knowledge. If our children have to be innovators and entrepreneurs, they will have to create something new out of the information they have now. Even Newtonian laws will not last forever. Our kids have to take the world beyond Newtonian laws into the next generation of learning. So what is the known pool of knowledge? They will have to glean from that what is necessary and create new knowledge. And that gap is where the teacher just nurtures them, pushes them, involves them, raises their curiosity and leaves it for them. It's like leaving a child with a puzzle. You can't help the child to make the puzzle. That will take away all his interest.
Yeah.
He'll give it one kick and he'll walk off.
Yes.
A student has to be just given a clue, a hint, a drop, and let him figure it out for himself, like he's unraveling a mystery.
Yeah.
And let him come and tell you that this is what I discovered, or this is something that's never been heard of that I now know. And that's really what the teacher has to do, spark that interest, put that little drop of curiosity, and leave it to the child then to, complete the puzzle and then show off. Using technology to learn is very passive learning, and we don't want to make our children technology addicts. So whenever possible, we want our children to go out, seek for themselves. Recently they went to Dharavi to learn about small scale industry and how such things actually happen. So some of our parents were a little taken aback that we were sending our children to Dharavi, but if you had to learn about how from poverty they've actually come up and it's become a paradigm of entrepreneurship used as an example all over the world, you have to go there and see for yourself. We are too bound in by what the board expects, and therefore we try to cater to boards. But when we know what the child needs, we are going to bypass the requirements of the board to see that I have a live classroom where learning is happening, and I also finally do what the board expects me to do, because that is not rocket science.
Yeah, that's true.
Teachers must be the most highly paid professionals in the society, because they create all other professions. And let the light of inspiration continue in their hearts, because as they say, you can never see how far a teacher's impact will go. It is an infinite way of touching a child's life and creating the future generations. So let them take themselves really seriously and do it, because the future of the world depends on our teachers.